Welcome to my channel, and today I thought I would give you guys an update on my diabetic journey and how things are going and fill you in on where I am at the moment. So we are now on to week 26, 27 of the program, which means that we are now halfway through. So I've done the first 12 weeks of the liquid diet and then the 12 weeks of food reintroduction, and we're now officially on to food maintenance. If you are interested in seeing about the first two stages of my diabetic journey, then I will link to the videos in the description bar below. And if you would like to hear how I progress from here on, please subscribe so that you get notifications and updates. Don't forget to hit that notification bell to get the notification through. To date, today is Wednesday the 13th of September. We had a meeting last Wednesday, and at that meeting I was weighed in at 81.1 kilos, which is, and I have the conversions down here for you, I am now 12 stone 11 pounds or 178 pounds. Again, to find out the original statistics, then you can go and have a look at my first diabetic video. Which means that to date, from the 23rd of February to today, I have lost a total of 24.6 kilos, which is 3 stone 2 pounds, or 54 and a quarter pounds. That means that I have lost my daughter's entire body weight, so I'm quite pleased with that. My last HbA1c reading was normal, within normal parameters, at 32, and my blood pressure has dropped dramatically down to 120/74, which is healthy. I've got a meeting with my doctor on Friday to talk about my cholesterol levels, and basically I am now getting to a point where I could be classed as no longer diabetic, but I have to keep remembering that I will always be diabetic. This is for life, so I just need to make sure that my weight is down. So I thought, because some people have said to me, oh, it's a really hard diet, how can we do it? I thought I would give you my top tips for coping with the rapid weight loss part of the diet. So at number one, the first thing that I can think of to help you get through your diet is to drink lots of water. Now, I bought myself a 650ml refillable bottle, and I make sure that I drink 4 of these per day, and that gives me the amount that I need to drink at least 2.25 liters of water per day, particularly when you're on the food replacement section of the diet, because you are not getting any water from the food that you're eating, because you're not eating food. Yes, you're getting water from the soups and shakes, but you need more water than that to function. And only for the first few days do you end up peeing a lot. It's okay, it passes. Your body learns how to cope with that extra water. So keep drinking water, or tea or coffee. There is an allowance in the early stages of the diet of 50 mils of skimmed milk per day. So I used to split that into 25 mils, and that would go into my coffee, and I started taking my tea black. I've been taking my tea black for a while. On that front, if you want to have an interesting taste in your tea, then my suggestion is to go for one of the slightly different black teas. My preferences were Earl Grey and Darjeeling. So my second tip on that front is, you will get bored of drinking water. Trust me. But finding savoury drinks is really difficult. So I have here, these are One Brands no calorie drinks. Yes, they do have aspartame, but if you flip them open and you do one little squirt into your water, it's just enough to flavour the water without actually being enough to you to get that aspartame taste, I found. And I have about 4 or 5 of these. One of them lives in my handbag, and everywhere I go, if I'm just feeling like having something different from plain water, I put a squirt into my water bottle, and that's my drink for the day. If you can find yourself a Cambridge diet consultant, Cambridge do a, I'll link it in the box down below, but they do a drink supplement that goes in with hot water that is called Golden Vegetable or something like that. and it is a powder that you add to hot water, and it's kind of like having a soup but without any calories in it. So you add it, you can add it to your soup for a bit of flavoring, but you can also add it to hot water just on its own and drink that like you would drink a hot drink like coffee, and it will give you another feeling of fullness. Right, my second tip for you is find yourself a non-food related hobby, something that will keep you occupied. I find anything that keeps my hand and brain occupied distracts me away from eating food. So you might take up knitting or crochet or embroidery or drawing or colouring or any number of things. I make jewellery for some of the income that we get in this household. Not a huge amount, but you know, I make steampunk jewellery, and so I found that I was doing a bit more of that. I also took up a new hobby of making my own makeup. One of the things that I have found as a result of this diet is that I am more confident in how I look, and I'm taking better care of my face and my skin. And it's been kind of nice to be a bit of an alchemist and sit in the corner and come up with my own concoctions. So yeah, it's been fun. I highly recommend it. Good hobby to do. My third tip is on the meal replacement part of the diet. You're on 800 calories a day. If you are not already exercising, do not attempt to take up any more exercise. You'll, for the first week or two, you will be exhausted and you will want to fall asleep a lot. Try to resist, but actually cutting out caffeine from your diet will also do that as well. And there's caffeine that we get in all sorts of things that we don't necessarily get in coffee. Don't forget, tea does have caffeine in it. It's just a small amount of it. You will be drinking less hot drinks, so you won't be getting as much coffee. But you'll also be avoiding chocolate, which has caffeine in it, and other things that have caffeine in it. If you are walking, then keep up that walking if you can. But if you can't, don't beat yourself up. You remember that you are functioning on 800 calories a day. You are effectively starving your body. So cut it a break and give it a rest. It'll be fine. I didn't exercise throughout the whole of the first 12 weeks because I'd done my back in October and I hadn't been exercising, and the advice was don't exercise, so I didn't. I have now changed that. I now do small, moderate amounts of walking because my back is still giving me problems. My next tip is, if you go on this program and you are having fortnightly weigh-ins, you'll be very pleased with the amount of weight that you're losing every other week. And the temptation is to get yourself a weighing machine of some description and weigh yourself every day. My advice to you is don't weigh yourself every day. I've set myself an alarm on my phone that goes off at 5:30 on a Wednesday afternoon, and that reminds me to weigh myself at 5:30, which coincides with the beginning of the meeting that we have now monthly, but then it was fortnightly. And the reason that I suggest that you do that is so that on the interim weeks you are still excited by the amount of weight that you've lost, because that will give you the incentive to keep on losing weight. The next tip that I have for you is things that you can eat that are free snacks. During the liquid replacement part of the diet, there's very little that you can have as a free snack. Basically, we're talking sugar-free Polo mints, Australians call them Lifesavers, any of those sorts of sweets, the strong mints and stuff, those are absolutely fine. The sugar-free Tic Tacs and sugar-free chewing gum. However, as I discovered the hard way, too much of artificial sweetener can cause havoc with your system. And how do I put this delicately? I don't know if I can put it delicately. You will probably need to know where the toilets are if you have too much of artificial sweetener. So limit the amount of artificial sweeteners, and it will vary from person to person. For me, it was half a pack. Half a pack of Polo mints had me running to the loos. So just go carefully on those, because they can have an adverse side effect. but they are really, really helpful. Once you start on the meal replacement section of the diet, so the second 12 weeks, there are lots of free things that you can add into your diet. So I have found that if I carry around a small punnet of cherry tomatoes and snack on those, they're a great snack. Celery sticks, carrot sticks, radishes. I'm not a huge fan of radishes, so they're not my thing, but one of the other guys on the group says that they're absolutely wonderful. Cucumber sticks, any of those vegetable sticks are absolutely great. Again, don't forget to keep drinking your water because you need to keep your system fluid. Now, my next tip for you is about what happens when you get back onto the food reintroduction section. Keeping track of the calories that you are eating becomes of fairly big importance. So I have found that the best one that I can find that helps me out is MyFitnessPal. This is a free app that is downloadable. I've got the iPhone version, but there are other versions available. And this allows you to track all sorts of information about yourself. More importantly, it allows you to track not only the food that you're eating, but also it will feed into the onboard Nike application. The onboard health application that's on iPhones and keep track of your paces. So as long as you keep your phone on your person, then it will work out quite well for you. It has a diary that allows you to add the foods that you want, and it can also, you can enter in recipes that you cook on a regular basis, and this will give you the portion control. So it's a really very powerful app. There is a paid for version, or you can just go with the free version. I use the free version. The other app that I use that is quite helpful is the Apple Health app. It's the one with the little, it's this one here. Okay, it just says health. Right, so it allows you to keep track of your weight. I haven't entered in my weight at the moment, but what you can do is you can enter in your weight into your application of, I enter it into my Fitness Pal, and it then translates straight into health. And then I can see, and then this is the one that tracks your paces and will feed back into the health app. So the two working side by side. I also have a Urban Leaf by Bellabeat. This is a fitness tracker that clips onto my lapel and just looks like a piece of jewelry. So I'm not wearing anything on my wrist because I don't like them. And it will track my paces as well. So, and that also feeds into my Fitness Pal and into the Apple Health app as well. So between them, my Fitness Pal, the Health app, and the Bellabeat app that's downloadable with the Leaf, keep track of all of my exercise that I'm doing, my food, my weight. I can include my blood pressure. There's a place for notes so I can add in my latest HbA1c measurement. It's quite powerful. My next tip for you is that in the first initial weeks of the diet, you will get very cold regardless of the time of year. If, as we did, we started in February and it was quite cold, I was absolutely freezing for the first 2 to 3 weeks. So my advice to you, before you start the program, order some extra leggings. Doesn't matter how thick or thin they are. If you really want to get the winter weight ones, I just ordered some nice extra layers to put on underneath my trousers, so that I just was wearing two layers in winter. And I bought myself some thermal socks to just keep my feet warm. And I found that by having those extra leggings and the socks, it was enough for me to cope with the cold. I also have a blanket that I, when I'm sitting here in the living room and it gets a bit cold, then I put that on, and that just keeps the chill away from me. As it happens, prior to losing weight, you would not have caught me dead wearing leggings on their own. And now that I'm thin enough, I'm now wearing leggings with long tunic tops, and they actually look really quite good on me. So in a certain way, it means that I've had to replace less of my trousers because I've been able to supplement what I've got with the leggings that I bought back in February. And this comes to my final tip. Clothing. Now, everyone keeps saying to me, this is a great excuse for you to go out shopping and buy yourself some more clothes. Well, yeah, It is. But buying new clothes costs money. And actually, I really like some of the clothes that I own. I bought them from a wonderful boutique in Australia that did come here for a while. And I really like my clothes an awful lot. And I don't want to outgrow my clothes. So I've gone through my wardrobe and I've found that there are a dozen or so items that I kept from when they were too small because I couldn't bear to part with them. They were expensive and I really liked them and now I fit into them. And I've bought a few new items. I went out the other day and bought my first pair of jeans for 13 years. And I think the last pair that I bought were a US size 14. Which is a UK 20 or an Australian 22. And the pair that I bought are a UK 14, which I think is a US 8 and an Australian 12. So that feels really good to get those on, and they look pretty good too. But because I don't want to just swap out my entire wardrobe, I've done a couple of things. First of all, I have bought... This is called a fashion fit, and I will put a link to the description of it in the description box. I bought this from Amazon, and it was around about £6. It's about 8 centimetres long, and it's elasticated. And the idea is that you clip it onto the back of your trousers on that side, and then a little bit further over on that side, and it holds your trousers in. And that was great for about the first 3 weeks. And then I discovered that my trousers were getting too big. So what I then bought was these, slightly longer. These are the ones that you buy to hold your fitted sheet onto your bed. And they come in packs of four for around about £4.5. Again, I'll put a link in the description box. These ones go on the waistbands of my trousers and I clip them up at the front and around to the side, about halfway across the back, and they just hold the sides of my trousers in a little bit. There's a bit of a gather that happens on the side and they just stop my trousers from falling down. Because most of my trousers have elasticated waists, this doesn't look silly. Even on the couple of the trousers that I've got that don't have a fully elasticated waists, it keeps the front flat and the back flat, and the sides, no one really notices that there's a bit of extra gathering happening on there. And then I just wear my shirt over the top. Let's see if I can show you on the trousers that I'm wearing today. Right, so here we go. You can see I've got a waistband there. It's clipped at the front there and at the back here. And it just holds a little bit of the extra of the waistband in, and then my shirt goes over the top of that, and no one can see that extra waistband. Right, and then this short one has now gone, it now goes onto the backs of my t-shirts and cardigans and things. And what I do is I hang a cardigan or whatever it is that I'm wearing up top, I hang that onto a hanger, and then I run a finger down from the shoulder line to about the waistline, and I just cinch the waistline in a bit on the back to cinch the waist in a bit. And what that does is it stops the shoulders from falling off. So even though I am smaller on my shoulders and therefore my cardigans are all still a bit too big for me, the cinching in of the waist has made things a little bit smaller and things fall off. So to that end, I've managed to find some more decorative ones. These are made out of leather, and they're not stretchy, which means they won't work on my trousers, but they will work on my cardigans and my shirts, and I can adjust them and make them a little bit smaller if I need to. But the same principle here: cinch it on one side, cinch it on the other, and it just pulls the waist in so that the shirt doesn't look too big on me and it doesn't fall off my shoulders as badly. And I've bought one of those in black, one in purple, and then I'm wearing the pink one today on the back of this cardigan. And I don't think I can show you how it works. So there you have, there are my top tips for coping with a meal replacement diet. I hope you found this helpful. If you liked it, please give this video a thumbs up, because that will help me a huge amount. And please subscribe to my channel, and I will keep you updated on how my weight loss goes and how much I know is happening with the program that I've been on in my local area. So I hope this video finds you well. Thank you so much for joining me. Love you lots, and I will talk to you again soon.